Good afternoon, friends. So today I am going to discuss with you four problems of which has been asked in the previous NET as well as in GATE examinations. So let's start with the first one. So it said that the 31p animal spectrum of P4S3 consists of. So you have to tell how many lines of are formed in P4S3 in the 13p animal spectrum. Okay. So first of all, you have to know the structure of P4S3, right? So the structure of P4S3 is right. So basically we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 PS bond and we have 3 PP bond, right? Okay, now you can see that this 3 phosphorus are in same environment, right? So these 3 phosphorus are in same environment, so this 3 phosphorus will give a doublet for this, because this is in different environment. So for this phosphorus, this 3 phosphorus will give a doublet, right? And for this 3 phosphorus, this phosphorus will give a quartet, because this 3 phosphorus are in same environment. So the I value of phosphorus is half. So if we have 3 phosphorus, so 2 into 3 into half plus 1, that is 4, that is a quartet. Okay, and if you have 1 phosphorus, then it will be a doublet. Okay, so the answer will be doublet and quartet. Fine. Okay, so the next one is the 1H animal spectrum of HD. Okay, it's not H2, HD consists of what? So HDs. So the I value is 1 for D, right? So we have 1D, so it will be 2Ni plus 1, right? So 2 into 1D into 1 value plus 1, so this will be a triplet. Okay, but this triplet will not follow Pascal's triangle, right? Will not follow Pascal's triangle, right? So these three will be like 1:1:1, because Pascal triangle is only for I value is equal to half, but it has I value 1, so it will be 1:1:1, not 1:2:1, right? Okay, so the next one is the proton NMR and the 31p NMR spectral patterns for CHFPCl2Hol2, right? So CHFPCl2Hol2. Okay, so I value is half for hydrogen, phosphorus and fluorine, right? So these are the NMR active nuclei, right? So let's say for hydrogen, so 1H NMR, right? 1H NMR. So we have a fluorine. So first is, fluorine has a half value, it has 1 fluorine. So 2 into 1 into half plus 1, that will come as 2. So for fluorine, it will split into 2 lines, right? Now we have 2 phosphorus and I value is half. So it will be 2 into 2 into half plus 1, that is 3. So for phosphorus, it will split into 3 lines, right? So this is the 1H spectrum, right? And here the ratio is 1:1, this is for fluorine, right? For phosphorus splitting, it will be 1:2:1, right? And this will be 1:2:1. Okay, fine. Now for 31P, for hydrogen, it is splitting, for one hydrogen, it will split like this, okay? And then for fluorine, we have 1 fluorine, I value is half, so it will again split into two lines, right? So here ratio is 1:1, and here is it is also 1:1. Okay, fine. So this is how this spectral pattern will look, right? Now the next is the 13th speed spectra of acetone D6 as septate in the ratio. So for acetone D6 it will be a septate, but we have to find the ratio. It is acetone D6, right? So D3C CO CD3. So we have to find the 13C spectrum. So this carbon, both of these carbons are identical, right? So we have 3 deuterium, so it will be 2. So I value is 1 for deuterium, right? So it is 2Ni plus 1, that is equal to 2 into 3 deuterium into 1 plus 1. So it will be a septate. Now what will be the ratio, intensity ratio? Okay. So if we have 1 deuterium, if you have 1 deuterium, then 2 into 1 into 1 plus 1, so it will be a 3. So the ratio, so the pattern or the ratio, splitting ratio will be 1:1:1, right? As I said here. Fine. Now if we have 2 deuterium, then it will be 2 into 2 into 1 plus 1, that is equal to 5. So 5 lines. So how the pattern look like? You have to do like this. In the earlier one you got 1:1:1. Now do like this, 1:1:1. This is 3, and then 4 times. Then again, because if we do like this, it will be 4 lines, but we have 5 lines. So 1:1:1, right? So now it will come as 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. So if we have 2 deuterium, the lines will split in the ratio of 1:2:3:2:1. Okay. Now if you have 3 deuterium, like in case of acetone D6. In case of acetone D6, we have 3 deuterium, right? So it will be 2:3:1+1 is septate, right? So how to do? 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. Again, add it like this 2 times to get, because it's for 5 times, it's for 7 times. So 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So we are basically getting 1:1:3:6:7:6:3:1. Okay. Right. So if we have 3 deuterium, like in acetone D6, the septate will split in the ratio 1:3:6:7:6:3:1. Right. So this is how you have to do this one. Right. So these are few examples I discussed. Now I will come up with more and more examples on NMR spectroscopy, as well as some problems which are mixed, like NMR, IR, mass. Okay, so hope you like the video, and thanks for watching.